Hey guys, my baby Bugaboo's nursery here. Thanks for stopping by. For today's theme Thursday, I thought I would go ahead and show you how to make a pacifier clip since today's theme is handmade. I have a bunch of things on my desk here that I thought I'd just show you first. First of all, I ordered this big bag of pacifier clips. I don't know what you call these here. What does it say here? Teething toy clip holders, pacifier clip holders. I ordered this from Amazon and it was a large bag. I think there's 10 different colors in here. I can go ahead and put the link in the descriptions below. Got good reviews. It was cheap and there's plenty of colors to choose from. So I thought they'd be good to have on hand so you can match them with various outfits and beads. And then secondly, I have a collection of beads here that I want to choose from. And some scissors, obviously, and some string, twine, elastic, whatever you're going to use to string your pacifier clip together with. I chose this cord because it kind of matches the beads that I want to use, and it is relatively small, so I can get it to go through the holes of some of my smaller beads right here. So the theme that I'm kind of going for with this particular pacifier clip is nature, natural earth tones. It's going to be for Creven, who is my woodland elf doll. And his, you know, kind of theme is the forest because he's a woodland elf. So this is one of his passies. It is a fox. And that's because he has a spirit animal, and that is a fox. And he will be coming shortly and joining us in the nursery. They're going to be the best of buds. And yeah, so first things first, what you're gonna wanna do is kind of like take the beads that you're interested in using and you're going to start messing around with different patterns to see what you like. And I do this before I start stringing just because it's really annoying to like get going and then decide you don't like something and have to take it all off the string. So I just kind of lay it out on the table first. Whoa, and there we go. They're going to start rolling everywhere. This bigger bead right here, I'm not sure I'm going to use it. It's a little large to me. I think it's a little clunky. So now that I have these other beads out, I think I'm going to set that aside and focus on this size. I have a little tray here to catch my beads. So that way when they're loose, they're not going to roll out all over the place. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and start playing around with this and then show you what I've come up with after the fact. I am really liking the way that this looks right now. And a couple things to keep in mind. There are really small beads on this pacifier clip, so this would never be anything safe to use with a real baby. Creven is a reborn doll, so he is not going to choke on these pieces. And second, It looks long right now, and it's about the size that I want it to be. But when I put these beads on the string, they will be oriented sideways, so it might end up being a little bit shorter. So keep that in mind. And I just wanted to point out that, excuse me, it looks more, I think, aesthetically pleasing if it's a symmetrical design. So I went ahead and went with the bigger bead in the middle. And I just wanted to make sure that to the right and to the left of the bead, my pattern was the same. So if you need to add length and you want to add beads, you're gonna probably want to add the same bead on the left side or on one side of your string as you do on the other side, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna go ahead now and start stringing these beads up. I decided to go with this darker color string, and in order to get the loop at the top of a pacifier clip, which you need to attach a pacifier to it, you're gonna wanna double up on your string. So I'm gonna take an eyeball this. I don't have an exact measurement for this. I'm gonna take a piece and I'm gonna double it up like that. And this looks plenty big. It's better to cut too big than too small. So I'm gonna go ahead and trim this right here. Now on this part, this is the loop you're gonna wanna create to string a passy through it. You can see with this one in particular, you're gonna wanna be able to string it through a handle and then pull the passy clip back up through the loop. So you want your loop to be big enough to fit your beads through it. So I'm gonna say about this long. And then I'm gonna take that and I'm gonna tie a knot to hold that size for me. I'm gonna try to double knot that so that my beads don't slip through it and so it doesn't come apart. All right, and from there, I can take the other end where there will be two pieces and you're gonna start to bead, gonna string these beads. I'm gonna trim these up so they're even at the end. It'll just be easier. All right. So you just start with one end and work your way down. Okay, so that took me longer than I thought, and I had some trouble with some of my beads. Some of these smaller beads had very small holes. And so a pointer that I would have for you, or a tip, I guess, would be that if you're finding you're having a lot of trouble with any particular bead, just swap it out for the same bead, because not all the holes are uniform. So some of the beads just, I don't know what was going on in there, but the string was not going through. And I went ahead and swapped it out for the same bead, just a different one. And there were no issues whatsoever, but I'm really liking how this turned out. I'm liking the colors. So now I need to go ahead and find a clip that I feel would complement the colors. I'm thinking either white or green or clear. There's the clear. Let's see. I think I'm gonna go with clear. It just has kind of like a minimalist type look to it. And then I can really match any pacifier onto it. this particular pacifier has a clear handle anyways. So I feel like that'll look good. All right, so this is what the end of the clip looks like. And all you're gonna do is you're going to tie this to the end. Now, before you do that, you're gonna wanna kinda close this off. So I'm gonna knot this as close to the last bead as I possibly can, just to keep those beads from slipping around too much. And I'm gonna double knot that. To keep that knot bigger than the last hole on my bead. I don't know if you can see that. And then I'm gonna go ahead and however you need to do this to make sure it stays on is fine. Now it is gonna slide from side to side because it is kind of a long narrow clasp. So I'm gonna go ahead and just do this knot a couple different times. So again, I just strung it through there and I'm gonna tie that. And I want it to be as close to my last knot as possible. I'm gonna do this at least, I'm gonna do it like three times, I think. Now, you could, if your hole was big enough, restring this extra bit through the beads to just to keep it there and to make sure that it doesn't come untied. I'm gonna go ahead and just trim it for now. And if it comes untied, I will problem solve that later. So this is what it looks like on the end. And there we go. So let's go ahead and attach our passy. So here's that loop around that I was talking about. You're just gonna put this loop at the end through any opening of the pacifier, and then you're gonna take this loop and you're gonna thread your pacifier clip through. Just grabs on like that. All right, so let's go ahead and get Creven. I was gonna go ahead and change him in what I think is homemade. I'm not sure it looks homemade to me, but it for sure is knitted. So I'm gonna go ahead and put him in that outfit and we'll try out this passy clip on him. This looks kind of long because he's a tiny little baby, but that's okay because it'll fit some of my bigger dolls as well. So let's go take you over there.
Don't worry, be happy now. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Don't worry.